This is What's It All About, and I'm John Rydgren with Mel Franklin of The Temptations. Mel's the one with the fantastically deep voice.
The band played on. I hated my voice. Getting kind of hungry, but you forgot to bring something to eat. And then all of a sudden, it turned out to be my best asset.
Bend your knee and bow your head.
My voice.
And tote that bar until you're dead.
My best asset.
And mama, man talk going around town saying that papa had three outside children and another wife.
And that ain't right.
Boys.
Stealing cars, robbing bars, muggings, drugs, ratting them.
I hated my voice. And then all of a sudden, it turned out to be my best asset.
That's Mel Franklin of The Temptations. They've been together for about 10 years now, and Mel says they still love what happens when they step out in front of an audience.
Hey, look here. Even in Las Vegas, where everybody's supposed to be, you know, like black tie and reserved and everything, and it was like a roar, like a woo, wow, you know, really great kind of thing. And it touches you, you know, it touches you and it transcends you. There is, you know, like, there is no greater joy to me in life than singing on stage other than when I pray.
We're talking with Mel Franklin of The Temptations, and, of course, success usually doesn't come easy. Before they were ever The Temptations, they worked so hard to keep their act together. And so we were talking about what it takes.
More than anybody else that you all have talked to and the type of a show that it is, I think that we, The Temptations, are living proof of God. And I say that because of the trials that we've been through and the amount of success that we've had in spite of it.
Don't change your style now that you've reached the top. Don't choose your friends by what they got.
The glitter and gleam.
Like everyday people, you're just a human being.
Back now with Mel Franklin, of course, of The Temptations. Everybody in the music field doesn't make it. Takes something special, obviously. We talked about it.
I think it's a matter of sacrifice. I'm talking about before the days that we had to hit records. I'm talking about back in the 50s. You know, like when we really starting out in the first part of the 60s, when guys say, hey, look here, man, I can make more money doing something else. See, their interest and their desire was not to sing and entertain, but to make money. You know, I ain't care about the money. You know, like my mother works hard, Richard's mother, she worked hard, and between the two women there, they saw to it that I was fine. You know, like I had shoes and stuff, and I had lunch money, okay, and then like I hustled enough around town, I shined shoes or took out garbage or shoveled snow or sold shoes at the shoe store or washed dishes or whatever I could do, you know, to help me through school and help them out, but more than anything, to help me to be able to sing. You know, and other people that were with us, you know, like they wanted to have all the luxuries and the fine things that life brought you. And they were true to this desire, whereas we were true to the desire to really want to sing and entertain. And consequently, all the other finer things of life came anyway. You know, because, you know, like we made successful what was really real to us. I'd like to be able to just spend all my time concentrating on how to make people happy, man. Because there's not enough happiness. It never is.
Mel Franklin and The Temptations. We had a chance to talk about their spiritual awareness.
We're Christians, and, you know, like I say that, you know, with it in mind, in my father's house, there are many mansions. I mean, because, you know, like, in this system, you know, like, there are many, many, many ways that people do believe. And I do know that in the Temptations organization, it all boils down to Christians. Well, we all grew up in church, you know. We grew up in church. Church is very much a part of our lives. To me, God is Jehovah. To me, God is God that was written of in Genesis all the way through Revelations. So, you know, like, I can understand other people, like believing, like the forces and the vibes and all this kind of stuff. But I feel like I have a foot in the doorway of the truth. You see, I feel like whether or not I have the strength to live it or not, I pray for the strength every daily, to grow and grow and be more like Jesus.
To be more like Jesus. That's what Mel Franklin of The Temptations feels. And Mel says it works. And that's what it's all about.